When exactly did you decide to do the video, and why then?
I filed a police report when I was younger, but nothing happened, so I dropped it. Now, that doesn't mean I forgot about it. I'm 21 now, and this happened to me when I was about 8 years old, and her birthday had been 18 or 19. One day, I was just on Facebook, and Facebook sometimes suggests friends to you. It suggested him. That name sounded familiar, so I clicked on it. I was able to look at his stuff and his pictures, and as soon as I found out who it was, about all those memories and pain again, I found out he was in charge of a kid's wrestling program, and it made me feel like I need to make some kind of noise. With Herbert being a child predator, my videos are pretty popular on YouTube, and gave me an outlet to get his name out there with a bigger audience, but I didn't think it would go like that viral.
Tell me about it.
I made it on the 24th of August around in 2012, and I released it 2 days later. It happened in like 5 days, because on the 5th of September or something like that, it was on the news. One of the kids came forward. His mom saw it the day after I posted it. She knew that something was going on with her son. When Herbert started taking him outside of the wrestling program, inviting him to his house, especially because I'm from Florida, she knew that there's no way this person in Florida made up the story and made her press charges.
In November, they arrested him in Mexico.
Yes.
What did you think when you heard he was arrested?
I felt like I finally saved little Maynard. I could tell myself he's behind bars and they caught him and he's going to pay for it now.
How did he approach you?
Herbert's mother would sell candy for, you know, a living. One day, I wanted candy, so I went to her house because she was my neighbor. His mom wasn't home, but he was. He invited me to the house, locked the door, and when he started asking me perverted things, my mind just went blank. And he molested me, and he said, "Don't tell anybody," and bribed me with candy. From that moment, I didn't tell anybody. I was very afraid.
Where are you today?
It's hard for me to be myself. It's hard for me to be outgoing because of my childhood, but it really made me start utilizing my art more. I would start painting more, making videos. That was just my way of expressing my self-esteem that I had lost, just being artistic. So that's how I coped with it.
And I've seen that you portray Rihanna.
It's really just a hobby because I get to be someone else and I get to, you know, be this person that I admire. And I'll play another artist. Really, it's just a way for me to have fun and be someone else. And it's just cool that, you know, something like that brings other people together, so.
Also, tell me about meeting her.
I met her outside of her LA show in 2011. I went dressed up as her, like a big poofy flower dress, and, like her red hair. And she got out of the car and she said, "I remember you. You said you're going to wear a big poofy flower dress." We took a couple pictures, and right before she left, I was crying, and she said, "You tweeted me." I related to her because she went through a tough childhood, and so did I.
In doing the video, what was the response from, like, your friends, family, people that you knew?
People that I knew would say, "Why didn't you tell me?" When they heard that about me, their support went out to me. People that I never even met messaged me and tell me their stories and how it's helped them. Even people that I knew told me their things that happened to them. And you'd be shocked, like, how many people things like this happen to all the time.
That's what you said in the video, that it happens when people aren't looking.
Right.
Are you going to be involved in the trial?
I would love to stand up in court and testify against them, because that's something that I was not able to do as a child. But it's really up to, like, the judge and everything. I will be in California in April, so I'm looking forward to meeting the other victim and his mother and give them a big hug for telling their story, because if that victim never came forward and said what happened to him with Herbert, I would have never had another witness or someone else to testify against him. Things like this happen a lot, so I'm glad that I have an outlet. I'm glad that I have a voice now, and I want everyone to know that they have their own voice and that it's never too late.